us, Lord, to the desert. Lead us through the wilderness. Through this journey we will follow, for we long to see your face. In this time of sacred struggle, in this time of sacrifice, we rejoice, for we remember that you lead us into life. Gracious God, mercy is your name. Redeeming love, you give your life away. Gracious God, we bless your holy name. Presence, Lord, we're thirsting for your grace. When consuming all but you, Lord, all we gain is emptiness. Gracious God, mercy is your name. Redeeming love, you give your life away. Gracious God, we bless your holy name. Receiving love, we give our lives away. Teach us, Lord, who is our neighbor? Is it friend or enemy? When we welcome or condemn them, it is you who let us see. Gracious God, mercy is your name. Redeeming love, you give your life away. Gracious God, we bless your holy name. Receiving love, we give our lives away.
Thank you for watching Mass at St. Francis Cabrini Catholic Church in Omaha, Nebraska. Our celebrant is Father Damian Zuerlein.
Good evening and welcome to the Holy Sacrifice, the Mass at St. Francis Cabrini. Our opening hymn today is Glory and Praise to Our God, number 547. Glory and Praise to Our God, number 547. Please stand.
Glory and praise to our God, who alone gives light to our days. Many are the blessings he bears to those who trust in his ways. We, the daughters and sons of him who built the valleys and plains, praise the wonders our God has done in every heart that sings. Glory and praise to our God, who alone gives light to our days. Many are the blessings he bears to those who trust in his ways. In his wisdom he strengthens us like gold that's tested in fire. Though the power of sin prevails, our God is there to save. Glory and praise to our God, who alone gives light to our days. Many are the blessings he bears to those who trust in his ways.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Gathered to thank our God, we prepare by calling to mind our need for God's mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the way. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you are the truth. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us of our sin, and bring us to everlasting life.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good. God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy, have mercy. Alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Almighty, ever-living God, grant that we may always conform our will to yours and serve your majesty in sincerity of heart. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord to his anointed, Cyrus, whose right hand I grasp, subduing nations before him and making kings run in service, opening doors before him and leaving the gates unbarred. For the sake of Jacob, my servant of Israel, my chosen one, I have called you by your name, giving you a title, though you knew me not. I am the Lord, and there is no other. There is no God besides me. It is I who arm you, though you know me not, so that toward the rising and the setting of the sun, people may know that there is none beside me. I am the Lord, and there is no other. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Our psalm today is The Lord is Kind and Merciful, number Psalm 103, The Lord is Kind and Merciful.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. Paul, Silvanus, and Timothy, to the Church of the Thessalonians, in God the Father and the Lord Jesus Christ, grace to you and peace. We give thanks to God always for all of you, remembering you in our prayers, unceasingly calling to mind your work of faith and labor of love and endurance in the hope of our Lord Jesus Christ. Before our God and Father, knowing, brothers and sisters loved by God, how you were chosen. For our gospel did not come to you in word alone, but also in power and in the Holy Spirit with much conviction. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Gospel according to Matthew. The Pharisees went off and plotted how they might entrap Jesus in speech. They sent their disciples to him with the Herodians saying, "Teacher, we know that you are a truthful man and that you teach the way of God in accordance with the truth. And you are not concerned with anyone's opinion. For you do not regard a person's status. Tell us then, what is your opinion? Is it lawful to pay the census tax to Caesar or not?" Knowing their malice, Jesus said, "Why are you testing me, you hypocrites? Show me the coin that pays the census tax." Then they handed him the Roman coin. He said to them, "Whose image is this? And whose inscription?" They replied, "Caesar's." At that he said to them, "Then repay to Caesar what belongs to Caesar, and to God what belongs to God." The Gospel of the Lord. Repay to Caesar what belongs to Caesar, and repay to God what belongs to God. So the question we might ask ourselves is, what belongs to Caesar, and what belongs to God? I had the privilege, not long ago, of doing a burial service at Omaha's National Cemetery. It was for a veteran, obviously, and a parishioner. And the National Cemetery is reserved for those people who have served our country and their spouses. But truthfully, as I was going out there, I was really nervous. Because I had never done a burial service where they also had the military portion. The rifle salute and the presentation of the flags and the taps. And I had also never been to the National Cemetery. So when I got there, I asked the guy who was in charge. I said, "You know, I'm not that familiar. Tell me how things go here." And he said, "We do things here in the same way we train our soldiers.
God first, family second, country third. And it really struck me because the way he said it, it was like it was from his core. And the other thing that struck me is when I think about patriotism, love of country, military always comes to mind. And yet, even though they clearly love their country, they recognize the right order of things. God first. So we might ask ourselves the question, in our own lives, is God first? And a maybe more fundamental question for us is, at the core of my being, who am I? Because I think we tend to settle for much less than God desires for us. If I were to ask you, tell me something about you, you would probably say, I'm an accountant, or I'm in construction, or I'm a teacher. You might say, I'm Italian, or Irish. I'm an American. I'm a Democrat. I'm a Republican. And those things are all fine and good. They're a part of us, but they don't truly define who we are and whose we are. As some of you know, my wife Ann and I are new grandparents. And I know what you might be thinking, how can a couple who's in their 30s have grandkids? Maybe that's not what you were thinking. But just a few weeks ago, we baptized our grandson, Noah, right here. And he was a total stinker. He cried from the very beginning until the very end. And he wasn't just kind of whimpering. He was bawling. And yet, even with that, it was a tremendously profound experience for us. For me, as a deacon, as a dad, as a grandpa. Why? Because Noah became a child of God, configured to Christ, whose image Noah now bears. The same is true for all of us through our baptism. We became sons and daughters of God, brothers and sisters of Jesus, heirs to the kingdom. We were made in the image and likeness of God. Remember the coin from the gospel passage. It bared the image of Caesar. For you and I, we bear the image of God. So what we repay to God is us, you and me. Let's pray for the grace to always remember at the core of our identity who we are and whose we are.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible, I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us offer our prayers to our Heavenly Father.
For wisdom, that God will guide us in being faithful citizens without compromising our discipleship and service of God, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all God's people, that formed in the image and likeness of God, we will manifest God's presence in our workplaces, our families, in our society. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For greater respect for life, that the Holy Spirit will open all to a deeper recognition of the beauty and mystery of life in all its stages. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all recovering from storms and wildfires, that God will give them strength, a spirit of hope, and a supportive community so that they may rebuild their lives. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all educational leaders, that God will give them insight and courage as they strive to balance the educational needs with the concerns for the safety of students and staff. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our friends and family members who have died, especially Bruno and Grace Kayleen, that they may experience the fullness of life in God's presence forever. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for those intentions we hold in the privacy of our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, hear our prayers and answer them through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Our offertory hymn today is You Are Mine, number 456. You Are Mine, number 456. You each by name.
follow me, I will bring you home. I love you and you are mine.
Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
For our good and good of all, His holy church.
Amen. Grant us, Lord, we pray, a sincere respect for your gifts, and through the purifying action of your grace, that we may be cleansed by the very mysteries we serve through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in you we live and move and have our being. And while in this body we not only experience the daily effects of your care, but even now possess the pledge of life eternal. For having received the first fruits of the Spirit, through whom you raised up Jesus from the dead, we hope for an everlasting share in the Paschal mystery. And so with all the angels we praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and George, our Bishop. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, that we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. The Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sin but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
An act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot, at this moment, receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Bread of Angels, number 365.
Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, that benefiting from participation in heavenly things, we may be helped by what you give in this present age and prepared for the gifts that are eternal through Christ our Lord. So tomorrow's the drive-through sauce and meatballs, so you need to get like 6 months' worth of sauce and meatballs when you come by. So I think each of you are, I think there are orders like 300 meatballs apiece is what people are getting, and several gallons of sauce. So that's great. We should be able to make it through the first hour or two before we run out, but please come and get some sauce and meatballs, and hopefully you can find some pasta somewhere. We do have bread, though. So we have Orsi's bread. So you can just get a meatball sandwich, which is great, too. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
As we go forth in song this evening, our closing hymn is Blessed Are They, number 725. Blessed Are They, number 725.
Blessed are they, the poor in spirit, theirs is the kingdom of God. Blessed are they, full of sorrow, they shall be consoled. Rejoice and be glad. Blessed are you.
Thank you for watching Mass at St. Francis Cabrini Catholic Church in Omaha, Nebraska. Please share this experience with friends and family. You can make donations and get updates about the parish on our website at stcabriniomaha.org. Thank you for watching Mass at St. Francis Cabrini Catholic Church in Omaha, Nebraska. Please share this experience with friends and family. You can make donations and get updates about the parish on our website at stcabriniomaha.org.